नमस्ते गुरुकुलियंस, आई वेलकम यू टू आवर साइंस क्लास ऑफ क्लास 8 एंड वी आर स्टडीइंग इन आवर लास्ट क्लासेस चैप्टर सम। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट होम एंड आई होप यू ऑल आर यूजिंग योर टाइम वाइजली एंड सिक्योरली। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो इन आवर लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट साउंड। ओके, लाइक व्हाट इज साउंड, हाउ साउंड प्रोड्यूस्ड, हाउ साउंड प्रोपगेट, and also we have studied about the structure of ear in the part 3 of our lecture. Okay, so in part 4 today we are going to study characteristic of sound. So as you know students, in part 3 I have just introduced you that what are the characteristic we are going to study in sound, and also I have clarified some term related to it. Okay, so students, which topic we are going to study? Yes, characteristic of sound. Okay students, very interesting topic and it is very very important topic also for your future. Okay, so characteristic of sound, characteristic of sound, or you can say characteristic of sound wave. Okay, so in your book there are mainly 5-6 characteristics are given, so I will tell you among those what are the most important one. Okay, so characteristic of sound, or you can say quality which help you to distinguish between different types of sound. Okay, so characteristic of sound, let's start. Okay, before going to this topic, let me just re-explain you previous some definition which we have discussed. Okay, so what are those definition? First is oscillatory motion. Wave. Okay, so these two definitions are going to re-explain you characteristic of sound. Okay, so the parameter which we are going to study in this topic, those parameters are very very important to understand wave, or you can say to understand the sound wave. Okay, because wave have some parameter associated with it. Now characteristic of sound, let's start with oscillatory motion. So what is oscillatory motion? The to and fro motion of any particle about its mean position. Suppose I started my journey from here, I go to this side and again come back to this side. Again I also go to that side and come back to this side. So this type of motion is called the oscillatory motion. Motion of a spring is a oscillatory motion. The to and fro motion of any particle or back and forth motion of any particle, it is known as oscillatory motion. Back and forth means aage or piche. Okay students, so that type of motion is known as oscillatory motion. Now wave, we also studied wave. So what happens if any disturbance is created in any medium at a particular place? So transfer of disturbance from one location to another location without any transfer of the medium. Okay, only the energy is transferred. So this type of thing, it is known as wave. Okay, how the wave produce or propagate? The wave produced by the periodic motion of the particle which are there in the medium. Because the particle vibrate, they transfer the energy, they do not move from one place to another place. Okay students, so these are the two definitions which you need to know. Okay, now to explain this topic, I will draw a pendulum. In our last class I have cleared some term to you related to pendulum, and in class 7th also you have studied in detail about pendulum, periodic motion, oscillatory motion. Okay, so now it is the advanced version of it. Okay, so rest position of the pendulum, it is known as mean position. Okay, now left and right position of pendulum, these two end, it is known as extreme position. Okay, so beta, whenever you are learning science, try to learn the term by relating it with something. Okay, now suppose in mathematics you studied about line or line segment, line segment say A or B. So line, this line segment have two extreme point. Extreme point means end point. Similarly, related with here, the pendulum has extreme position or those position, the maximum position of the pendulum. And these both extreme position are same usually. Okay, boys. Like suppose if the pendulum go 5 meters this side, so pendulum also go 5 meters to this side also. Okay. So these are the extreme position. Okay. Now, whenever we are drawing the wave is drawn usually like this way. Okay, like this way. So whenever we are doing the sound wave, what happen? I told you guys earlier also, sound propagate by the help of compression and rarefaction. Or what happen whenever we speak or whenever the body vibrate, it compress the molecules. Compress means compression, particle become closer, or you can say pressure is high. So whenever we are drawing the sound wave, we relate it with the pressure versus distance. So it is pressure versus distance graph. That means how the air molecule, how the pressure increase or decrease with the help of distance. Okay, so here the pressure is increasing, here the pressure is decreasing, low pressure, high pressure. Okay, so with the distance it vary. Now, so beta, one more definition is there, that is known as one oscillation. Let us start with one oscillation or simple oscillation. Suppose the pendulum, it is O position, it is A position, it is B position. If the pendulum start from A and again come back to A, it is known as oscillation, or you can say one oscillation. Okay, this is called oscillations. And if it comes to A one time, that is called one oscillation. Suppose I start moving from here, I go to that side and again come back to that position. Okay, so it is called oscillation, or you can say one oscillation. Understand? Similarly here, this is known as one oscillation. If it keep on moving, then that is known as oscillations. Okay, so similarly here, in oscillation, actually in the graphical form, this position is known as the mean position or rest position of the pendulum. Okay, so one oscillation, either if it start from A, come back to A, one oscillation. If it start from B, come back to B, one oscillation. But if it start from O, go to A, again come back to O, then go to B, again come back to O, this is called one oscillation. Okay, you see again, first it go from O to A, then it goes from O A to B, then it again come back to B to O, this is called one oscillation. Okay students, so try to draw the graph with it. Okay, so it is a rest position, it is at rest. Okay, so we start from here. Now the pendulum go to extreme position, that means its distance or pressure become increased. As the body or tuning fork move outwards, so what happen? Pressure increase. So what happen? From this end to this end, pressure is increasing. When it come back to O, then what will happen? Pressure is decreasing. So what will happen? Pressure is decreasing. And when it come back to O, again it come to rest position. Okay, then it go to B side, pressure again decrease. Understand? When it go toward this side, air molecule become compressed, pressure will increase. But when it go backward, the pressure will decrease because the air molecule will expand. Okay students, so what will happen? The particle travel this distance, but when it move from B to O again, then what will happen? The pressure will start increasing. So pressure is increasing, it come back to here. Okay, so in this way you can draw the waveform or wave pattern like this way by the help of a pendulum. Okay students, so this type of motion, to and fro motion of the pendulum, it is known as oscillatory motion, and when it come back to same position, it is known as one oscillation. So by the help of this, we are going to explain you that what are the characteristics, and all these things are very, very important. You should understand the fundamental to understand the characteristic of sound. Okay, like here in the pendulum we say one oscillation. Similarly, when the spring vibrate outward, come inward, this is called one oscillation. But in the wave we don't say oscillation, we say one wave. So what is one wave? So this distance, it is known as one wave. Okay, so what is this one wave? Okay students, so now come back to our main topic, characteristic of sound. Let us begin with it. I hope students you have understand these following concept, and these are all the very main concepts. Okay, now start with the very first characteristic of sound. First is time period.
Time mean it is simply a time,
so it is denoted or written by the letter capital T. Okay, so what is a time period? Time period is time taken by one wave. Okay, so what is time period? Time taken by one wave, or
see here carefully,
time taken by one wave is called time period. This is a time period, like one wave is traveling. Now this you measure time, and that is known as time period. Similarly here, time taken by in one oscillation means whatever time the bob take to complete one oscillation. I told you the definition of one oscillation. So whatever time taken by the pendulum to complete one oscillation, that is known as time period. So time taken by the one wave or time taken for one oscillation, it is known as the time period. Okay students, and as you know the SI unit of time is second, so SI unit of time period is also second. Okay students, next one is wavelength. You will not find in your book of 8th class, you will find or study in detail in 9th class. Okay, so what is wavelength? Just study the basic definition. Okay, so what is wavelength? Distance traveled by one wave. Distance traveled by one wave, it is known as a wavelength. Okay, so this much is, it is one wave. So in this much wave, how much distance it has covered? So that is given by the wavelength. Okay, so what is wavelength? Distance traveled by a wave, it is known as wavelength of any sound or wavelength of any light. Okay students, so as you know it is a distance. SI unit of distance is meter. So SI unit of wavelength is also meter. Okay, now next one is frequency. Okay, so students, I'm relating with these characteristic with both the diagram, so try to understand it. Frequency is number of oscillation, one oscillation, like I cleared you, number of oscillation in 1 second. Now see with the help of pendulum, number of oscillation traveled by the pendulum in 1 second, you said 1 second. So in that much time, how much oscillation it has completed? Take an example of spring. You compress the spring and note the time for 1 second, and the spring will vibrate. So the number of oscillation of the spring in 1 second, it is known as frequency. But when we are talking about in the wave form, so this is called cycles. These are called one wave or one cycle. Okay, so number of cycle in 1 second. Okay, so what is frequency? Number of cycle or wave in one second is called as frequency. Okay students, so frequency is frequency. Now SI unit of frequency is hertz. Is hertz, and it is written by the letter HZ, H capital is small z. Okay, so it is given after the name scientist Sir Hertz. Okay, so he has discovered the quantity frequency, and that's why the unit hertz is given after his name. Okay, now next quantity, it is amplitude. Okay, so what is amplitude? The maximum displacement. Maximum displacement of the pendulum or of the bomb from the mean position. So it is known as the amplitude. So see here in the diagram of pendulum, it is a mean position. So what I say, maximum displacement from the mean position. Displacement is simply a distance. So it is a mean position, it is an extreme position. So this much distance, okay, distance traveled by the pendulum, maximum distance traveled by pendulum, it is known as the amplitude. So this much height, it is known as the amplitude of the pendulum. Okay, but when we are talking about in the waveform, like I told you before, where is the mean position? This central line, which is a reference line, which is taken at a zero level. Okay, so this is considered as a mean position. Okay, now the maximum displacement or maximum distance from the mean position. So it is the mean position where the maximum distance it travel here. So this maximum distance, it is known as amplitude. Okay, so it is known as amplitude. Similarly, this is mean position and this is the maximum displacement. So this much distance is also known as amplitude. And always both the amplitude of the wave are same generally. Okay, students. So these are the four main characteristics of sound which you need to understand. Okay, so there are some other three more characteristics are also there, and their function is to distinguish between different types of sound. So let us study about the other characteristic of sound. Okay, I hope you are able to understand. I recall this definition again. Now time period. What is time period? Time taken by the one wave. It is known as time period, or time taken for one oscillation is called time period. Wavelength, distance traveled by one wave is called wavelength. It is a distance. SI unit is meter. Frequency, number of cycle in 1 second. Means in 1 second, how much number of cycle is completed? That is given by the frequency. Or number of oscillation in 1 second, it is known as frequency. Next one, amplitude. What is amplitude? Amplitude is maximum distance traveled by the wave from the mean position to mean position. So maximum distance or displacement from the mean position. Here also, it is mean position to the maximum position or the extreme position. So this much maximum distance or displacement, it is known as the amplitude of the pendulum. Okay, students. Now let us study about the other characteristic of the sound. Now, as I told you, their main function is to differentiate or distinguish between different types of sound. Okay, so what are those characteristics? Let me recall it, that those are four. Fifth one is loudness. So my children, loudness. Suppose when you're watching TV, if the volume is low, or whenever you're listening to the music or movie, or you're watching movie on a cell phone by using the earphone. So what happens if the volume is too low? At that time, what will happen? You don't hear the sound clearly. So what you will do at that time? You take the remote control TV, or you push the volume button of the phone. So when you turn the remote, okay, or when you push some button in the remote, so what will happen? The voice of the TV will increase, or you can say the voice will become loud. Okay, so when you are making the remote, when you are increasing the volume of the TV by the help of remote control,
or by that what you are doing, you are making the sound loud. So in that, what is mainly changing? Either frequency, either time period, either amplitude. So students, whenever you are increasing the volume of anything, you are basically increasing the amplitude. Okay, so loudness is that characteristic of sound which mainly depend upon on the amplitude. Okay, if the amplitude is very very high, then the sound will be louder. If the amplitude is low, then sound will be small one. Okay, take an example of drums. When you beat a drum feebly or slowly, so what will happen? It vibrates slowly, and what you can say, the sound which has come out to be, it is very very soft sound. Okay, or it is very feeble sound, means a small sound. But when you beat a drum strongly, then what will happen in that moment? The drum will vibrate very very fast. Okay, so in that case, the sound comes out to be a louder one. So loudness is that characteristic of sound which depend upon amplitude. Depend upon amplitude. Okay, so larger the amplitude of the sound or larger the amplitude of the wave, so larger will be the loudness, smaller the amplitude, smaller will be the loudness of the sound. So SI unit of loudness is decibel. What is it? Decibel. D-E-C-I-B-E-L. Decibel, it is denoted by the letter dB. Either D small, small b, or either small d, capital B. Okay, decibel. Now, students, so there are many different type of sound you hear basically. Okay, like you can say the loudness will give you two type of sound. Okay, depending on loudness, sound will be two type, either loud sound, either feeble sound. Feeble, or you can say soft sound. Depending upon the loudness, loud sound is that sound which have high amplitude, or feeble sound is that sound which have low amplitude, or that type of sound is also known as soft sound. Okay, next characteristic of sound, it is known as pitch. Pitch refers to the shrillness of sound. Pitch refers the shrillness of sound. Now you will ask me, sir, what is the meaning of shrillness? Beta, shrillness means tikhapan. Okay, means how sharp it is. Okay, so pitch refers to the shrillness of a sound. Understand? So pitch mainly depend on frequency. It mainly depend upon frequency. How it depend upon frequency? If the frequency of any type of sound or any type of wave is very very high, then pitch is very very high. But if the frequency of any sound is very very low, then the pitch will be small. Okay, so in generally you cannot measure the pitch. So if you hear two different types of sound, like the sound of a male, sound of a female, so you can generally recognize them and distinguish them by the help of pitch, even though you cannot measure the pitch by measuring the frequency. Okay, but you can tell, your mind can distinguish, yes, it is of high pitch, it is of low pitch. Generally the male voice is of low pitch voice or less shrill voice. Okay, because they have low frequency voice. But whenever the small baby cry, okay, or whenever the female or the woman speak, their sound is very very sharp or shrill. Okay, so women have high pitch sound as compared to a male which have low pitch sound. Another example you can take, the sound of a quail early in the morning which you hear, that have high pitch or high frequency as compared to a bull sound or a cow sound. Okay students, so this is the characteristic that is known as pitch. Okay, now the last characteristic which we are going to study, that is known as quality. Quality. Now what is quality? What is quality, beta? To understand quality, if I give you two different types of sound, ok octave which have same loudness, same pitch. So to distinguish between those type of sound, okay, so distinguish two sound of same loudness, same pitch is called quality. Okay, suppose you hear two different types of sound, both have same loudness, both have same pitch. So how you recognize them? Beta, you recognize them by the help of a quality. So what is quality? It is a characteristic of sound which help you to recognize or distinguish between two different types of sound depending upon the loudness and depending upon the pitch. Okay, so that's how you're able to recognize them. Okay students, now how you're able to recognize different types of sound? It mainly you are able to recognize them because each sound have different type of waveform. Like it is this type of wave is there. Now generally we have square wave also, so it is different waveform. We have triangle wave also. Okay, so these are different wave. So depending upon the waveform, you are able to recognize different type of sound, even though they have same loudness, even though they have same pitch. So you are able to recognize them. Okay, you are able to recognize the sound come out from the guitar or come out from the you can say flute. Okay, so how factor called quality. Okay students, now there are two more definition which I just want you to learn or understand. So you basically heard, you can mention into the note also, extra notes or extra point, you can mention it over there. So very first definition is tone. You know about tone, you have heard about it is a tone. Now what is the meaning of a tone? If a sound wave consists of only one frequency, if any sound signal is there which have only one frequency sound, okay, so that type of sound is known as tone. But if a sound contain a mixture of frequency, means it have different types of frequency, so that type of sound is referred as notes. Okay, like sa, re, ga, ma. So sa, re, ga, ma, what is this? Sa have same frequency, that's a tone. Re have same frequency, that is a tone. But when you mix all together, sa, re, ga, ma, so all these become a note. Understand? So intermixing of different frequency of sound, that is considered as a note. But a sound which consists of only one frequency, that is considered as tone. Now beta students, it is very, very, you can say that whenever we are hearing either tone, either note, so note appear pleasing to us because it contains different frequency. Or generally whenever we are speaking, we cannot speak only one frequency sound, we speak many kind of frequency at that point of time. Okay, so that's why note is pleasing to us because it is more richer as compared to the tone. Okay, so students, here I end my lecture with the help of these characteristics. In our next lecture, I will bring some numericals depending upon this characteristic, and depending on the same characteristic, I will help you to solve some type of waveform. So I can ask you that you are able to understand the concept or not. This is a very main concept of the class, and if you understand all these points, it will be very, very important for you in class 9th also, because you are going to study the same concept. So students, if you understand this thing carefully, you are able to understand it. Okay, thank you students, take care, namaste.